We have shown how Gauss solved the problem of finding the sum 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus up to 100. In Gauss' solution, we reduce the problem of finding the sum of different natural numbers to the problem of finding the sum of 50 equal numbers. It is very natural in mathematics to generalize concepts and results. A natural small generalization of the prior result would be to find the sum 1 plus 2 plus 3 up to n of the first n natural numbers. It is also a natural impulse to try to solve similar problems with similar solutions. In this case, we will try to solve the problem using the same idea as Gauss with a very small modification. As in the prior lecture, let us call t sub n equal 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus up to n, the nth triangular number. We can easily rearrange the order of the elements in the addition in reverse order. Therefore, we can write t sub n equal n plus n minus 1 plus n minus 2 plus up to 3 plus 2 plus 1. If we add these two equalities, we get 2 times t sub n equal n plus 1 plus n plus 1, and all of them are n plus 1. And as in Gauss' solution to the problem, we have found again that adding a number from the beginning of the sequence to one from the end, the sum stays constant. The right-hand side this time is also very easy to compute. We have n of those terms. Therefore, t sub n equal n times n plus 1 over 2. This solution was easy to find because the solution is based on the same idea as Gauss's solution for the special case 1 plus 2 plus 3 up to 100. We already point out why Gauss's solution works, and the same is true here. The solution works by translating the problem of finding the sum of different numbers to finding the sum of equal numbers, and we are able to produce the equal numbers by conveniently rearranging the numbers in the sequence. In both cases, we are dealing with sequences of consecutive natural numbers. Can we generalize this a bit more? Yes, we can. What if instead of a sequence that starts on 1, we get a sequence that starts on a number a sub 1, and we obtain the next element by adding a constant natural number d? So the first element of this progression will be a sub 1. The second element is a sub 2 equal a sub 1 plus d, and a sub 3 equal a sub 1 plus 2 times d, and so on until a sub n equal a sub 1 plus n minus 1 times d. This progression is a bit more general than the sequence of natural numbers. First, it does start on an arbitrary number, and the difference of two consecutive terms is d instead of 1. Progressions that satisfy these conditions are called arithmetic progressions. Examples of arithmetic progressions are 1, 2, 3, up to 100, our special case. In this case, the first element is 1, and the value for d is 1. And another example is 2, 4, 6, up to 200. In this other example, the first element is 2, and the increment is 2. So we obtain each term by adding 2. Could we find a formula for the sum of the general arithmetic progression? That is, to find a sub 1 plus a sub 2 plus a sub 3 plus up to a sub n, where a sub k equal a sub 1 plus k minus 1 times d for k in 1 through n. To find this formula, we suspect that we may be able to encounter some invariant as before by adding terms from the beginning and the end of the progression. So we should be able to prove that a sub 1 plus a sub n equal a sub 2 plus a sub n minus 1, and pairing opposite terms of the sum, the result is constant, as in the previous special cases. That is, we should prove a sub k plus a sub n minus k minus 1 equal a sub 1 plus a sub n for k from 1 to n. We know by our definition that a sub k equal a sub 1 plus d times k minus 1, and also a sub n minus k minus 1 equal a sub 1 plus d times n minus k minus 1 minus 1. Adding both equalities, we get a sub k plus a sub n minus k minus 1 is equal to a sub 1 plus d times k minus 1 plus a sub 1 plus d times n minus k minus 1 minus 1. And this is equal to a sub 1 plus a sub 1 plus d times k minus 1 plus n minus k plus 1 minus 1. And this is equal to a sub 1 plus a sub n. Therefore, if we call s sub n equal a sub 1 plus a sub 2 plus a sub 3 plus up to a sub n, and rearranging the terms as before and adding both equalities, s sub n equal a sub n plus a sub n minus 1 plus a sub n minus 2 plus up to a sub 1, we get 2 times s sub n equal a sub 1 plus a sub n plus a sub 2 plus a sub n minus 1 plus up to a sub n plus a sub 1. But applying the prior result, we get that 2 times s sub n equal a sub 1 plus a sub n plus a sub 1 plus a sub n, and so on until the last one. And since there are any of those equal terms, we get s sub n equal a sub 1 plus a sub n times n over 2. Finally, we will propose some problems where you could apply similar solutions. Please send solutions to solutions@isallaboutmath.com.